everyone. In this video, I'm going to discuss and demonstrate the Rigoutat RIEC oboe, and I couldn't find any other videos online that discussed this oboe or demonstrated it, so I thought I'd make one to show the keywork features and the tone and other capabilities of the RIEC. So this is an excellent intermediate level oboe. This particular one was my first wooden oboe in high school. We got it new in late 1997, so it has high sentimental value for me. And I remember testing several used oboes at the time, and including Lorette, and finding that the new RIEC was better for the same price for what my interests were at the time. So the RIEC has a grenadilla wood body and metal lined tenon sockets, which adds strength to the joints. So to demonstrate what those are, this is what a tenon socket would look like. It's where one joint inserts into the other, and these are lined with metal, which adds a lot of strength and durability to the instrument, especially when you are assembling it or holding it by one joint or another. And I find that a lot of other student model instruments don't tend to have that. They just have a wooden socket, and so those tend to crack. So that's a really good feature of this. The RIEC does have a third octave key, which is a feature of some intermediate oboes and then all professional oboes. I'm not sure if it's a quirk just of this instrument or of all RIEC oboes, but when I depress the third octave key, as I'm doing right now, the third octave vent right here scarcely opens, and like on my Marigot that I use right now, there's a significant opening, and here I'm not noting any opening, barely. I haven't had any problems with this oboe. This has played very well for the high notes that use the third octave key, but I don't see a whole lot of opening there, so it may just be some kind of quirk. Moving further down the instrument, we see that all of the key pads in the upper joint do have an open hole, and that improves intonation for the trills. Most beginner oboes have solid touch plates without the holes here, and that's done to reduce any misplayed notes that happen from rolling your hand. So especially for people with smaller hands, if you are trying to use your left pinky keys over here, there's a tendency for your left ring finger to slip off as well when you're trying to reach for those lower notes. And so for that reason, the student instruments tend to have solid plates here instead of open holes. The RIEC was specifically designed to be ergonomic for people with smaller hands. So when I play this and I'm reaching for the lower notes, you can see that my left ring finger is rolling a little bit, but it's not significant enough to lose the seal over that hole. So this is designed really well, no matter what your hand size would be. So the RIEC has two keys in the left stack that are not present on many beginner and some intermediate oboes. One is the low B flat key, right here, which allows you to play the lowest possible note on the oboe. And there are two ways of observing that the oboe has the low B flat key. One is the presence of this third or outermost leaflet in the left pinky stack. And the other is if you are looking at the bell of the oboe, there will be keywork here if you have low B flat. So on the most basic student instruments like the Selmer plastic models that middle schools tend to loan out, there will just be two open holes right here, and so you can't play the low B flat unless you close your knees over the holes or have your instructor put his or her fingers over the tone holes at that time. So it's really not worth the effort in those cases. So I would really recommend for a beginner instrument or an intermediate that you really look for one that has low B flat. So that you're able to play all the range of the oboes. The other neat thing that's unique to the RIEC as compared to some other intermediate oboes is that it also has a low B flat resonance key. So the low B flat key is the larger one over here that will close when you play low B flat. And then the key right here is not always seen, even with low B flat. This is the resonance key, and it will open when the low B flat key is closed. And that helps to improve intonation on the lower note and take some of the buzzing and harsh edge off when you're playing that note. Okay, so going back up to the left pinky key stack, you'll also notice that this has an elevated central key, and that is the much sought after left hand F. So beginner models and some older intermediate student oboes don't have that. And it's possible to get away without a left hand F, but it's a really nice feature if you plan to go on in oboe. And so it's probably better to get accustomed to it sooner than later. So the regular fingering for F is holding down the first three keys of your left hand and then the first three fingers of your right hand with the ring finger of your right hand depressing this key right here. And that is the so-called right hand F key, and that's the standard fingering for playing an F. The difficulty with this is when you're playing a note that uses the D key, so this could be low D, low E flat, low C, low C sharp, any of those keys, or any of those notes where your right hand ring finger is being used, then it's very difficult to play an F if the F immediately precedes or immediately follows from any of those other notes. You'll have a slight blip in the sound because your finger can't really roll between those notes. So the way to work around that, if without a left hand F, is to play what's known as the forked F fingering. This is similar to playing an F on the soprano recorder, if any of you grew up playing that. It's where you will use your right index finger, leave your middle finger open, not touching any keys. Your right ring finger will touch the D key, and then for added intonation, your right pinky finger can depress the low E flat, or the E flat key. So the problem is that the forked F sounds kind of muffled and fuzzy, has a flat overtone to it, so we prefer to avoid playing that fingering if possible. So some of the earlier intermediate oboes tried to get around that by building in what they call an F resonance key. And that is that when you depress D to play the forked F fingering, you'll notice this extra key here that's called the F resonance, and it will help improve intonation for the forked F fingering of F so that you don't have to also bother with using your pinky finger down there. Still, that's not ideal for the fingering. The better option is to have the so-called left-hand F key, which you can see right here. The left-hand F key does exactly the same thing as the preferred right-hand F key fingering. So you'll notice that above the right-hand F key, there's this little tab right here. And if you follow that up along the length of the instrument, that connects with the left-hand F key. So when you play or depress left-hand F, it actually is closing the right-hand F key right here. So it's producing exactly the same conditions for the instrument. So for that reason, we prefer to use left F if you are, let's say, performing a D, F, D, F, D, F, or E flat F, E flat F, E flat F. That way you are able to free up your right-hand pinky to work, your right-hand index finger, right-hand ring finger to work on the D key. Okay, so finishing up the upper joint, the RIEC has the B to C sharp trill key, also serves the C to C sharp trill, and that's located between the A and the G keys. So right here, you'd use your left index, left ring finger to play that note. For some reason, the RIEC doesn't have the second C to D trill key, which would normally be located right about here. You can still play the C to D trill with this key. So you'd play that with your left middle finger. I don't know why this oboe doesn't have it, because I've seen simpler, more beginner oboes that do have the left trill key for C to D. So I'm not sure why it was removed here, except that it's really not essential. I have this key now on my full professional oboe, and I never use it. I've never used it. I have only ever used this for the C to D trill. So I don't think it's very essential. Okay, it doesn't seem like much of a loss. So that's the upper joint, and then the lower joint of the RIEC is also designed very ergonomically. The thumb rest is in a nice position. It's a little bit lower than what you find on a professional oboe, might be a little bit higher up here. And so having the thumb rest in a lower position allows the rest of your hand to be positioned a little bit further down so that it's an easier reach to all of the other lower keys down here. The other thing that we have is this F sharp extended key. So on some other oboes, this is the tone hole and the key are right on top of each other, so that your right hand index finger has to be positioned all the way up here, and then there's a bit of a reach for the rest of your fingers. So it's nice to have this extension right here. The extension is shaped a little bit differently than I've seen on some other oboes. On other oboes, this has a tab that sort of sticks outward. This is more of a comfortable indentation for just resting your finger a little bit further down. The other thing that's kind of neat about this particular RIEC is the split D key right here. This seems to be unusual for the RIEC. I've only seen a couple of pictures online of other RIECs that have that. The other RIEC oboes that I've seen have a solid touch plate here instead of the open ring. So the purpose of the split ring is to stabilize the tone for an E flat to an E trill. So the inner portion of the ring will stay down when you're playing E flat to E trill, so that the inner portion of the ring is stuck downward. So the drawback to having that open, or the split D ring, is that for people with smaller hands, it can be difficult to keep that tone hole entirely closed. Again, because this thumb rest is a little bit lower, it seems like it's an easier reach down to that key, and I personally have never had any problems covering that tone hole. So a split ring is necessary for a full professional oboe, but if you have a solid touch plate there, I think that's still not much of a problem for an intermediate level oboe. The RIEC does have that so-called banana key, which you can see right here. This is an alternative fingering for low C, so I actually can't reach it without my ring finger sliding off of the tone hole. So in the history of playing the oboe, I've never been able to successfully get a low C using that fingering. But it would be a nice feature when going from low C to C sharp, C to C sharp, if you're able to make that fingering work, if your fingers can reach that far. So I think those are all of the keywork features of the RIEC. One of the things I like is that its mechanism is really quiet. So this is quieter than any other oboes I've really played on. So in that regard, it's a really neat feature. Again, this is made of grenadilla wood, and I feel like this instrument has a narrower bore than some of the others. I'm not sure if just by looking you can tell, but this instrument does seem to have a pretty narrow bore. It does feel lighter than other instruments I've played on, so there's a noticeable difference, and it's a lot more comfortable to hold than a Leray or a Marigot. The one thing that I found about the tone, and again, I'm used to playing now on a Marigot, which has a very loud, full tone, because I tend to be a quieter player, so I like an instrument that can project without a whole lot of effort on my part. I have found the RIEC to be a bit softer. It doesn't have as much projection and spin that the professional oboes do. So in that sense, its sound quality is almost more like an English horn. It's pretty mellow, and it's able to blend, but I don't envision it piercing through an orchestra in the same way that you sometimes get with that shrill, almost oboe sound. So it's not a bright tone, there's much less ring to it, but this would be really good for chamber music playing, or if you're someone who tends to play louder and make your reeds a little bit more brassy, I think this would be a good compensation for that in a sense. There is a really even and stable tone. It's very easy response throughout the entire range, and I've never had any problems going from low B flat to high F or anywhere in between. It's really easy to play. Another thing I noticed about this oboe is that it is slightly sharper than my Marigot, and I'm not sure if this is all RIECs or just this instrument, so I'll demonstrate this in just a moment, and I don't have a good reed made for this right now because I don't play this oboe very frequently, so I would recommend building a longer reed than what I'm using here to help keep this instrument in tune. So let's hear how it sounds.